Okay, Scott.
I will tell you that the first time I treat these guys, I usually just use plain needles. Mm-hmm. Sometimes the second time or whatever, depending on how they're doing, I might use some other things, maybe a little laser, maybe electroacupuncture. Mm-hmm. But again, because I've never treated him before, this is sort of the plainest, see how he reacts, you know, that kind of thing.
Okay.
They usually will be very sleepy after their first treatment, so I won't let that worry you.
Okay.
They usually just want to go home, take a nap. That'll be that.
All right.
And that'll last anywhere from a few hours to maybe a day.
Sleeping?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
So is that because of all the endorphins?
All the endorphins.
Okay.
And right here, so you're going to have to stay.
She's not going anywhere.
Right.
She's staying. He goes, uh-oh, everybody's getting up.
It's here, like, what's going on?
All right.
Because it's not food, so...
supposed to be relaxing, to be quiet.
It's funny, the CD, this plane is actually called Through a Dog's Ear.
Uh-huh.
They made it specifically for dogs that were like in shelters in stressful situations. And so we figured these guys need help in that department. They're always going to be a little nervous.
Okay, what can I do?
You know, the more relaxed you are, the more relaxed he's going to be.
Okay.
So, honestly, I'd probably sit down again and just, you know, that way he'll know you're hanging out and not going anywhere.
Okay.
Hey, buddy.
Still want to be in there. Yeah, no, you're just fine.
All right.
I think, like I said, the first time's always kind of strange because they're going, I don't know what we're doing.
It's okay, Hunter.
Well, it starts happening usually once the needles have been in a little bit and they start kind of relaxing.
His face, he looks like he just had a shot of tequila.
He's a baby.
He's going to start dancing pretty soon.
Yeah. It's all right, Hunter.
Is it any speed you like is fine. I just know it's warm.
Looks like it's good. That's all right.
I was reading that different things. Depending on which way you turn the needles when you put them in, is it
particularly with people,
mm-hmm.
not so much with animals.
Oh, okay.
Ow! I just stinged my elbow.
Let's try not to get injured.
That would be good.
Yeah.
Almost. I stayed too. The depth of the needle that I put it in depends how it feels when I go to put it in. Sometimes they're not very deep, sometimes they're a little deeper. And you'll notice as we treat them, sometimes we'll do the same spots several times, sometimes we'll use different spots.
be relaxing you.
He says I haven't quite figured that out yet.
I tried doing some research on Wikipedia about acupuncture because I've always felt like a medium to light fascination with it. And it said that the exact origin of it is kind of unknown. Mm-hmm. So.
It is.
I don't know, it's like weird. And when I first heard of it, I was worried because in the Midwest they have a lot of lightning storms and whatnot.
I don't think you'd be walking around town with your needles anyway.
No,
I don't know. I'm a stand-up comedian over here, sorry.
I mean,
no.
This is back when I...
my nose decided to drip right when... No, I agree. You don't want the needles while you're out in the lightning storm. Actually, it's kind of interesting because... acupuncture lesson or not, but there was somebody, they named them Orsi, and it was a mummy that they found in the Alps between Italy and Switzerland. And that's one of the oldest people that they can document ever had acupuncture.
Wow.
And they found tattoo marks along this person's back, and they found little wood splinters in those areas. And they corresponded, when they x-rayed them, they corresponded to a lot of changes that was going on with his spine. And it was interesting because then those also corresponded to acupuncture points that were later put into words, basically. The Chinese were the first that actually decided to write it down and made kind of a study out of it. But a lot of people used it from all over the world. But it wasn't just the Chinese, they were just the first to write about it. So. But yeah, there's cases all over. It's just that this is the oldest dated mummy that they can find, so. It's kind of interesting. How you doing? Pretty good, huh?
So do you think they switched from wooden splinters to metal needles because of, like, what some would believe the Earth's magnetic poles might have an effect on them?
You know, maybe, but I will say that, for one thing, once they were able to figure out how to make metal, they could use their needles over and over again a lot easier, and they didn't tend to break off in the patient so easily.
Oh, yikes.
So I'm thinking that probably had more to do with it initially than the magnetic field, but I don't know that for sure. I have a set of, I would be going the other direction. I mean, they're big. They're... you know, like the size of that pen?
Mm.
That's one of the smallest ones in there.
Some
of them are much bigger.
Wow.
So.
Knitting needles.
Yeah.
Pretty much. So it's a little less barbaric, I think, then. But the system is the same. You know, how it works is the same. With animals, we'll sometimes put heat on the needles. I mentioned the electric acupuncture.
Yeah.
Sometimes we'll do that just to try to get things working a little more efficiently, just to open up the lines of energy a little bit better. But again, what I don't know with that, because sometimes even a young animal is incredibly sensitive to something, and then instead of sleeping for 12 hours, he'll sleep for 3 days. I mean, that's okay, but it worries people a little bit. And so anyway, I don't know what his energy level is, and we want to just try first with the plain needles and see. And sometimes the plain needles is all they need.
I tend to think the smaller the dog, the more energy they have, so...
To some degree.
Yeah. Which explains why chihuahuas can jump 6 feet in the air.
They can.
That's weird.
And then a nice sedentary St. Bernard, so Great Pyrenees.
Yeah, my grandparents had 2 St. Bernards when we were growing up.
Oh, really?
Mitzi and Boykin.
Oh, my goodness.
Those
were they friendly dogs?
They were friendly when my grandfather was around, but if we would arrive and the grandparents were in the house and we'd get out of the car, they would just bark ferociously, and then you'd go up, and he had this huge, huge pen. I think this thing was like 8 feet tall. It was pretty tall. It was taller than my grandpa, like by a couple feet. But they had a big pen that they had them in when they had company.
Mm-hmm.
But they were very friendly dogs. You know, when he was out and he'd let them out in the yard and they'd run around and stuff. They're just very, just wonderful dogs.
That's great.
Hope And he's going down.
The cutest eyes when he looks up like that.
It's like, hey, what's up?
Now he's beginning the flirtation.
Mm-hmm. He's like, you will be mine.
If I beg, will you take the needles out? Is that what you're asking?
Now how, they say, what, 12 minutes, 10 minutes? How long do you usually leave them in?
Yeah, I'm probably going to leave them in between 12 and 15. We'll see. When the needles start to loosen up a little bit, then we'll take them out. Some animals, they'll be in maybe 30, 40 minutes. Sometimes they might only be in 5 or 6 minutes. So this kind of problem, probably 12 to 15 the first time.
Mm-hmm.
And,
so is that because the muscles push them out, like, automatically?
They seem to loosen up. It's almost like the body's saying, okay, that's fine, and I'm done with them.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But I should mention that rarely you will have a dog that's a little more sore for about 5 or 6 hours. That's really rare.
Mm-hmm.
In people, it's quite common, but rarely happens in animals. You know, sometimes you can liken it to, again, after a massage, you know, you're getting all the toxins out.
Right.
And you've been working on your sore places, and so you can just feel a little, you know, ouchy. So, but that's really rare. I do encourage, if they want extra water, let them have extra water to drink.
Mm-hmm.
You know, let them kind of flush their system out a little bit.
Okay. Yeah, he's been drinking a lot of water since he came home from the hospital.
Well, he was on a lot of steroids for a few days, so I suspect that he's playing catch up with that.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, if Dr. Ahmed wants to put him on any medication, it's fine. It won't interfere with anything we're doing. I mean, hopefully he won't need it, but
if something happened, it's
no problem. And usually with these guys that are doing the dragging, when I start to treat them, I usually treat them fairly quick. I try to get them back in about a week, give or take.
Okay.
So I don't know what your schedule is, but
whatever he needs.
Do
I have the luxury of working from home, so.
Okay.
We need to bring him in, you know,
usually
or every other
week,
or
a week.
Yeah.
For the second treatment, and then after that, we'll see how his reflexes are and
okay.
What you have or haven't noticed, and then we can decide.
Hey, baby.
Hey, it's a good boy.
He almost looks like a RC toy.
Hunter, Hunter, look over here, baby.